Olivia, and today I'll be wrapping a few Christmas presents while taste testing 4 hard ciders. So these hard ciders are by the brand JK. These are actually made in Flushing. So if you don't know, Flushing, Michigan is a very small town, and I didn't know that they had the ability to like make and process and ferment cider there. Really, the apples that were used to make this, to make all of these, were actually grown in Flushing. So it's pretty cool, like, having something that's from Flushing. You can actually buy these at Allmark Orchards in Flushing. These are actually on sale from now until Christmas Eve. And they make a really good gift. And the best part is, you don't have to get 4 of one flavor. You can if you want to, but you can actually get 4 different flavors. They have 9 total to choose from. And you get to make your own 4-pack. So you could have 2 and 2, or 1 of each. Definitely recommend. I actually already started opening these 2. So this one is called Gold Rush Hard Cider, and it's a little less sweet than the Traverse City Cherry. The Traverse City Cherry so far has been my favorite out of these 2, so I'm gonna move these. I haven't opened these ones yet. This one is the Honeycrisp Haze. I'm guessing this is gonna be a sweet one, but I'm not sure. And Winterruption Spiced Farmhouse Cider. Ooh, nice and spicy. Just gonna sip this up there. Alright, so the way I can best describe the Traverse City Cherry is like a sweet, almost wine tasting, like, yeah, it almost is like a less sparkling version of champagne, but it's actually just hard cider, and the only ingredients in here are Michigan organic apple juice, Michigan tart cherry juice, and native yeast. So I don't know how they do it exactly. They do like ferment it, but there's no sulfites added. It's gluten-free. And they taste really good too. So like I said, this one is still really good. It's just definitely not as sweet as the Traverse City Cherry. If I could go back, I would have got 2 Traverse City Cherries and maybe even like a whole 4-pack of Traverse City Cherry just like extra. But yeah, I probably won't get the Gold Rush again. Maybe if I'm like in the mood for it, but this is more of like an acquired taste. This is more of like everyone could drink this. This one tastes like juice. It's like almost gone. Dakota was actually drinking this one earlier and he felt the same way. He liked mine better. So let's try the other ones. You do actually have to have a bottle opener to open these. Honeycrisp Haze. Oh yeah, that one's smooth. So definitely so far, top 2. This is probably my 2nd favorite so far. I haven't tried the Winterruption yet, but I'm kind of excited. There's even like snowflakes on the apples. I'm gonna go ahead and open this one, and I can alternate between these 2 and these 2. I'm not gonna drink the full bottles all at once. Just wanted to like taste test all of them. All right, so Winterruption. This one just says Spiced Farmhouse Cider. Winterruption actually has the highest alcohol percentage out of all of them. It has 6.9%. So they're all quite low. Honeycrisp Haze has 5.0% alcohol content. Traverse City Cherry has 4.5% alcohol content. So this one is the lowest, and it also is the sweetest. And then Gold Rush actually is in the middle. It has 5.5% alcohol. But surprisingly, out of both of these, it's only a 0.5% alcohol difference, and this one is a lot sweeter than Gold Rush. So yeah, I definitely recommend Honeycrisp Haze. Alright, so here we go with Winterruption. Taste test. Wow. I really like that. So, this actually has the highest alcohol content, but it is still sweeter than the Gold Rush. So this is 5.5% alcohol, and this is 6.9, but this is still a lot sweeter. So delicious with like simple ingredients. So now that I've tasted them all, definitely Traverse City Cherry is my number one. Winterruption, number two, very close, second. Honeycrisp Haze is number three. And our Gold Rush is number four. But it's still good. There's probably people out there too whose favorite one is the Gold Rush, one that's not so sweet. But I definitely like the one that's sweet fine. So this Traverse City Cherry one, I've like almost drank this whole thing. The other ones are still quite full, but oh, this is just so good. It tastes just like juice. So from now until Christmas Eve, all my orchards is actually doing a really good deal on the 4-packs. You can also get them individually as well. So if you go in there and customize your own 4-pack, you can give it as a gift or enjoy it yourself. Like we did, we got a 4-pack for us, and then we also got a 4-pack as a gift for someone. So definitely make a great gift, and I definitely recommend. It's actually really cool having drinks that are locally sourced. Interruption. This almost tastes like butterscotch candy. You can really taste the vanilla and the cinnamon. All right, so let's go ahead and. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and start wrapping presents. And I like going to next with everything because these are family Christmas presents and they might be touching. Actually, I have a few small box gifts that this would work perfect for, so I'm gonna save this for later. And you can always make it smaller, but you can never add on, and then it would be a whole waste of paper. So yeah, you always want to make sure you have a little bit extra, so then you can fold it. You create a clean edge. Instead of it being the cut side that could potentially be like ripped or torn, it's nice folded. They'll never know until they open it up, and they just crumple up and throw it away anyways. So, gotta open my tape. Oh, got some scotch tape. So Dollar Tree actually sells like 2 packs of tape. So this is $1, and it was $1 to get two, so might as well get four. Stock up. Is once you've actually folded your piece over and brought it up to match the middle, you actually want to lay your tape the same direction as the paper. So instead of going sideways like this, don't do that. Go with the seam, and it just somehow looks a million times better. So instead of laying, so if you're bringing the paper folds in together, you always want to lay it the same direction as those papers are meeting and never across. Because I used to do that as like a kid and it just looked bad. So don't do that. The other thing too, you kind of want to take like claws kind of push down so you don't want to like squish the item, which this item is like kind of plushy, so it won't be really squished, but you want to squish down the paper that's hanging off, and you can actually cut it. So because we overestimated it, we have a little bit of extra room to work with. And once you get it completely flattened, you're just gonna make these into creases. Lift up one front. We're gonna kind of like fold it into a triangle. Now for plushier items, just like this one, rather than a box, it's actually gonna like kind of move with you, which is not in your favor. So boxes are actually easier to do this too, but when you have a soft item, it does make it slightly harder. But you see how we got that completely flat? And the tighter you can make it, the better. So once we got one side, we're actually gonna hold that down as we flip the other side identical to the back. The same exact way. So now this is what we're working with. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side as well. Alright, since we got both sides folded, we're gonna go back to our first side and fold this point up to make this flap. And then we roll it up one more time. And like I said, with the plushy items, if they're soft and kind of have like some give, it will be a little harder. You just kind of go real easy. Yeah, wait till you see with the box item, it's a lot easier. And it's smoother, a smoother process for sure. And again, we laid the tape horizontally instead of vertically. So here we laid it vertically because that's how we folded the paper in, but because we folded the paper up and it created a horizontal line, we went on a horizontal line. So it's never always a horizontal and it's never always a vertical. It's always just whatever way you're folding that piece of paper at that exact time. So we're just gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other side. You always wanna handle your package with care. Even if the item isn't breakable, the paper actually is. I've actually gotten holes and rips in the corners before. And you know, if you're on your way to someone's house, you can't just like tape it, you know, if you don't have tape in the car. So very, very, very careful. And yeah, now it's ready to get the label on it so I don't mix them all up. So when you have your label, you actually have the dilemma of placing it in the corner and then placing a bow or ribbon in the middle, which I didn't want to do because it says Merry Christmas right here. But it would kind of look silly to place it over the snowman too. So if you always put the bow on a corner or in the middle, if it's like a plain wrapping paper, it will actually look the best. So put our little label on. See, sometimes the paper tears even when you do that. So that's why you always want to fold it over so it's a cleaner edge. And that part's not even seen. So here's another tip. For items like this, that's the same on both sides. You actually doesn't matter which way you lay it. So you can lay it forward, backwards, play the same both directions. But for something like this, like Play-Doh, typically people actually wrap their presents like this, to where the front of it is face up towards you. But then, as you're taping it and folding it over and attaching it, when they open it, they're actually gonna open it from this side as they tear it open. So what you want to do is actually flip it to the front side is actually going to face down away from you, and the back should be facing up towards you. So that way, you're actually going to open it and see the front of it. And then it actually makes it easier for you to. It's like this a lot with toys that have like a touch here or try me. So it makes it easier by making it a flat surface to tape instead of a lumpy one like that's completely open on the front. And it will kind of feel a little weird that it kind of goes down a little, but that's okay. You know, just don't like push too hard and make it wrinkled. So I'm going to go ahead and tape this. And if there's a pattern going continuous, you always want to try to line up like the patterns with each other. We're going to lay it the way of the same way as the seam. I just actually tore it, so this does happen to the best of us. So we'll have to scratch this piece of paper, unfortunately. And cut the piece. This happens though. too much. It's always good to have a little bit too much than a little bit not enough. So it's good to have a little too much than not enough. Another thing too, I just realized I actually wrapped it with the words going this way. So instead of it going like long ways, and that's completely okay. So now instead of putting the name tag up here, so instead of putting the name tag adjacent to the Merry Christmas, we're actually gonna put it going the same direction. So for this style, what we do is actually lay the shiny side on the outside, so the shiny side up, and lay it horizontal on your package. So we're going to tightly flip it over. So another way to do this is just to set the package down on top of it. So we're going to take them both up. Hold them so they're identical. Crisscross them. And then as we're crisscrossing on the way down, we're going to also rotate. So the one coming to the left side is going to go also to the back. And the one coming to the right side is going to go towards the front. We're going to pull tighter. But also make sure that the shiny side is up. It's gonna look something like this. And then we have to quickly flip it back over. And there we go. Sometimes I even like to do this, so as I tie it, I'll slip the bottom ribbon under first ribbon that we laid down, just to make it extra secure, tie it, use your finger for support, okay, so now it's nice and secure, we can make our bow. I'm going to take the shiny side, make sure the shiny side always remains on the outside. And tie it just like your shoe. I'm gonna flip up the loops of the bow like that. But don't do this. Don't do this. Don't give this gift to someone. It's not ready yet. Now, contrary to popular belief, this gift is not ready to give to someone. Do you see the fraying at the end of the ribbon? We're actually about to fix that. So with any pair of scissors, we're actually going to fold the two corners together. So these are the outside corners right here. And you want the outside corners to be the longest and the sharpest. So since these are the outside corners and we want them to be longer than the middle, we're gonna cut it in a diagonal. And it perfectly makes it. It makes it perfect tails every time. See, we're not even done, but look how much cleaner that looks already. So we're gonna go ahead and do that to the other side because, yeah, it's just gonna keep coming unraveled. So we need the two corners. Keep the outside ones in your watch. And since we have it so long still, if you accidentally cut it the opposite diagonal direction than you're supposed to, you'll be able to fix it. So we're going to do that diagonal cut one more time. So now, what we have to do is pull the bow really super tight. I actually have one that's too long, so I'm gonna cut it, but I'm not gonna cut it straight. I'm actually just gonna fold it over and cut it exactly how we just did. Just a little shorter. That's a lot better. Okay, only a few more presents to go, and I'm gonna enjoy some Honeycrisp haze. This only has two ingredients: organic Honeycrisp apples and natural yeast. So this is in third place. So I have an interruption. Yeah, see, even the interruption is so much sweeter than the Honeycrisp haze. Even though my alcohol percentage is actually higher in the interruption. Remember when these were still like tubes? Like I didn't have that. for clothing items, I always like to make sure the tag is forward so they can immediately see the size and the information in case they need to return it. Now for certain small gifts, like if it's something like this, like a do-rag, you can actually slip it in with their shirt as well, or whatever you're gifting. So that way it's just like one thing they can open. But I actually was doing something wrong. So when we really wrap it, we're gonna have it upside down like this. So with the tags forward though. For bulky items like sweatpants and sweatshirts, I do recommend folding them into a small, compact fold. Same with sweatshirts. This is just the lightest fold too, like if you're running low on paper. I'll have to buy some more to wrap through this. We're gonna go ahead and put some ribbon this time, like this. So if your ribbon isn't long enough to go around a really oblong object, just go like this. So we're gonna start at the same, except for this time vertical. And then just come right back without twisting. But at least to cover those other cookies. This is actually like wired ribbon, and you can still do it with wired ribbon as well. watching. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a like and let me know down below other things you want to see me try. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the bell for notifications. Bye!